أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم متكئين على شرف بطائنها من استبرق وجن الجنتين دان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان يرسل عليكما شواظ من نار ونحاس فلا تنتصران فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان صدق الله العلي العظيم lecture number 16 for second year class it is not mentioned second year class sorry for that second year class biology peritoneal dialysis we were discussing two methods if kidneys are failed if the kidneys are not performing function there is solution conditionally kidneys little a bit are working if kidneys 100% are not working there is no solution only one solution kidney transplantation a complex surgery the problem is that when the kidneys are working we can use two techniques to remove the urea artificially from the blood one is the hemodialysis I was being teaching you we were discussing in the last session in which that urea will be removed from the blood outside the body in a machine the dialyzer which consists of dialyzing membrane which consists of dialyzing fluid in which urea was being removed it was entered from the blood to the dialyzing fluid so that was the hemodialysis and also I told that technique is being used mostly even in Pakistan the technique which is less used in the world I am telling you now that is the peritoneal dialysis takes place in abdominal cavity almost same I told you you are three story building one is a brain cavity that is a top mimty of the house then thoracic cavity yes and then peritoneal cavity abdominal cavity which is situated just under the thoracic cavity dialyzing fluid in both cases are same important dialyzing fluid the composition of the dialyzing fluid in both cases what are the cases one is a peritoneal case one is a hemodialysis case I mean two type of the technique we are using but the fluid you are using that is the same because that fluid will attract the urea from the blood the difference is that in the peritoneal dialysis in abdominal cavity what you will happen in abdominal dialysis or peritoneal dialysis you will enter the blood directly into your abdominal cavity I will show the picture after some time and you will see that abdominal cavity situated at the ventral site of your digestive system just in front of intestine and that abdominal cavity is lined with the capillaries semi-permeable membranes are involved so semi-permeable membranes which is present in the abdominal cavity will behave like dialyzing membrane why I was telling this technique is more useful as quality wise because it will remove the more urea from the blood reason is that because you know inner semi-permeable membrane is natural one the semi-permeable membranes of abdominal cavity which is being used those are natural but the dialyzing membrane which was used in hemodialysis those are artificial those were made by humans so those are artificial and artificial machine will not work properly that's why little a bit better results in the peritoneal dialysis but problem in this dialysis is that some urea may remain in abdominal cavity because you have to drain dialyzing fluid you will enter dialyzing fluid into the body I will show the figure now I will indicate everything every procedure of that each procedure of that but I want to tell you when you will enter the fluid into abdominal cavity of course the urea absorption will be maximum but there is a threat little a bit risk factor might be some dialyzing fluid may not come more from abdominal cavity So you are not entering dialyzing fluid into the machine you are entering into a human and into human, in which the nitrogenous waste component is just like explosion. It's so much harmful, it causes coma, the nervous delusions will take place, nervous spasm will create, and nervous system will become inactive and person became under coma or became unconscious for a long time, and maybe death occur in this status. Therefore, urea removal from abdominal cavity is so crucial. That's why doctors may not be taking risks. That if we will enter the dialyzing fluid inside the abdominal cavity, maybe the urea will not come out. Urea will come out in dialyzing fluid. Might be dialyzing fluid may not be able to come out from abdominal cavity. So therefore, chronic and acute renal failure. These are the two words which you have to understand. Disease, you know, each person says, I am ill. Most of the people when go to doctor, they say, I am ill. There are, doctor asks two questions. This is an old disease. This is a new disease. At which time you felt the symptom of this disease? When the patient says, my disease is 7 years old, my disease is even 1 year old, the doctor says, oh my God, this is a chronic disease. Chronic disease means the doctor will get the history of that disease. He will interview you, he will ask everything, and you are better judge of your disease, and you will tell him right information, and the doctor will be able to treat that disease. Quite complicated for the doctor, but good in the sense because patient can tell a history of the disease. Acute disease, suddenly you are sitting in college, something happened. You are sitting in the home, something happened. Just like acute heart attack without any previous history, such attacks. So both types of renal failures are occurring. This is alarming news for us. Because, you know, I was telling you that when we will not drink plenty of the water, the stones are being produced. Stones are being released through the urethral orifice, through the kidneys, through the ureter, urinary bladder, urethra, urethral orifice. But we did not have any symptom. But might be when the more stones will gather, so it may damage the renal failure because ureter may be blocked. So therefore, we should drink plenty of the water also. And also, we should think we should know about the acute and the chronic renal failure. If we have the history, we should tell each thing to the doctor. And if we have no history, still we must be careful for any acute attack, renal attack. Okay, you will go back. Peritoneal dialysis. Peritoneal dialysis takes place in the peritoneal cavity, abdominal cavity. Peritoneal cavity, spelling P-E-R-I-P-E-R-I-T-O. P-E-R-I-T-O-N-E-A-L, peritoneal cavity. Okay, we'll go back to the discussion which I want to do, that peritoneal dialysis. And I will tell you now that how the cavity, peritoneal cavity is involved. I will tell you that you will enter dialyzing fluid into the cavity. Dialyzing fluid into the cavity. Look here, from here you will understand. So you are entering the dialyzing fluid into the cavity, peritoneal cavity. What is happening? Why you are entering? Because the dialyzing fluid is attracting the urea from the capillaries of the blood, who will not allow the useful molecules to go into dialyzing fluid. Semipermeable membrane of epithelial layer. Semipermeable membrane of epithelial. I am indicating epithelial layer. Epithelial layer, the inner layer of abdominal cavity. Look here. Inner layer of abdominal cavity will stop the flow of useful molecules and only allow the urea, which is a nitrogenous waste component, to go into dialyzing fluid. Where will be dialyzing fluid will stay? Dialyzing fluid will stay here. Dialyzing fluid will stay here. You enter dialyzing fluid inside this cavity, peritoneal cavity, abdominal cavity. What will happen? The nitrogenous waste component which were gathered here, you have to drain out, you have to remove. If they will not remove, they will become harmful for the body. They should not remain here. They should not remain here. Here should not remain. They should be removed from the body as soon as possible as the urea comes out from the body to the cavity. This epithelial layer is a natural semipermeable membrane surrounded by the capillaries. And these capillaries consist of blood, and blood consists of the urea, because kidneys are not properly working and urea is being gathered, and urea is harmful for the patient. So therefore, need to remove the urea as soon as possible. Otherwise, the patient will become little ill. little more ill, unconsciousness may occur better to remove the urea, to remove to do this phenomena of dialysis as soon as possible as a doctor advised. We should not delay for these because this is an emergency condition. Now we go back to the point we just wanted to say. Dialyzing fluid is called, you know what was the other name I allocated from the textbook also, that was in the hemodialysis? Dialysate, yes, of course, dialysate. The dialysis fluid, dialysate has the capacity to absorb the urea. You know, removal of the urea also very important. What was the precautionary point I told you during using of hemodialysis machine? That you have to replace the dialyzing fluid. You cannot stop the machine. The machine will continue. But you have to make such arrangements that during running machine is running and new fluid is entering into the dialyzing fluid. Mean you are entering fresh dialyzing fluid into a machine and old dialyzing fluid is distilled off, drained off, just like you are draining off. So what was the threat and risk factors? I told you that if you will not remove the dialyzing fluid from the machine, what will happen? Dialyzing fluid will increase the concentration of the urea. The urea concentration will increase in dialysis fluid. The urea concentration also present in the blood. So difference between high concentration, low concentration, called concentration gradient. And concentration gradient will thus urea, in spite of flowing from the blood to the dialyzing fluid, thing will become inverse. Thing will become more worse for the patient. Even without machine, he was good. You are entering urea from dialyzing fluid to the blood. So he is getting more urea. So therefore, you have to remove dialyzing fluid from the machine. Here, the same method is there. You have to remove the dialyzing fluid as soon as possible when it gets the enough urea. If the urea concentration become enough, the two drawbacks will occur. Once the blood will not give the urea to peritoneal cavity due to less concentration gradient. Second threat is that the might be urea start flowing from peritoneal cavity to the body. So this is the abdominal cavity. Yes, you was watching, you was telling, sir, tell us the positions. Yes, I was telling, this is the ventral position, clear? This is your dorsal position. This is a vertebral column. Look at the curve of vertebral column, 33 vertebrae. So these vertebrae names I will tell you in the next chapter, cervical vertebrae. This is a thoracic vertebrae. These are lumbar vertebrae. This is a coccyx, COCCYX. This is a coccyx, this is a sacrum. Coccyx, and coccyx also tail in the animal. You have no tail, it is closed. So you have no tail. If the tail come out, so we look like animal. So we are thankful to Creator that Creator did not make tail for us and closed coccyx. So we have reduced tail. You can say similar bone comes out of the body in the animals. Okay, these are extra discussion because you have to study in the next chapters. We have to study. So dialyzing fluid. One thing more I just want to say you. Before that, I would like to show you slide, then I will explain this one, because in the slide I was using one medicine, and one medicine I used, cyclosporine antibiotic. Cyclosporine word, where the slide, yes, I got. Students, when the dialyzing machine, I want your attention, because I think that will be a, if you are nephrologist, the study of the nephron is called nephrologist, and the doctors who do specialization in the kidneys, they are called nephrologists. Once again, you will say, why they are not called kidneyologists? Because they are studying the kidneys. Kidneys are important, but the cells in the kidneys, they work. Kidneys do not work. All kidneys do not work. What is the function of the renal pelvis? Just a cavity to collect the fluid? Only the area of the kidney which is present, which consists of the cortex and the medulla, which consists of nephron, that is important. So nephron are the functional unit. If the kidneys work, the nephrons work. So that's why nephrons are more important than the kidneys. So nephrologist, if you will specialize after MBBS in the kidneys, you will be referred as a nephrologist. So nephrologist, when they think that dialyzing machine is unable to perform accurate function for the patient and the patient kidneys are not properly working, because kidneys will work, the dialyzing machine will also work. If the kidneys are not working, so dialyzing machine 100% efficiency they cannot give, and you cannot remove the urea from the body. So you have only one solution as a nephrologist. You have to transplant the kidney. In the last chapter of first year, if you remember, I was teaching you lymphocyte B, lymphocyte T, and tissue rejection. In detail, we studied. What was the problem in the last topic of the last chapter? The problem was that when you was transplanting kidney, immunity system was identifying that bacteria is coming. You are giving kidney from outer side and you are just giving kidney for benefit of the patient, but your immunity system, cytokines, lymphocyte B, lymphocyte T, and cytotoxic cells, they are not identifying this as a bacteria, and they start to kill the bacteria, they start to reject the kidney, and they will not think any outside element will enter into the body, even bacteria enter, that's good, but any other thing like kidney, the over immunity system become emergency, and they declared emergency, that external persons come, external organ come, we have to reject this, this is called tissue rejection. So tissue rejection takes place. This is the major issue when you transplant the kidney. So what is the solution? The doctor use antibiotic cyclosporin. You are listening? Okay. Cyclosporin. I have to highlight cyclosporin. Cyclosporin antibiotic. They use it. Cyclosporin antibiotic. Why it is used? Cyclosporin is, you should write this word. You have pen and copy. If you have no pen and copy, repeat this lecture and write this one, which I am telling you now. Immunosuppressive drug. Cyclosporin is an immunosuppressive drug. IMMUNO. Immunosuppressive drug. Mean that it will suppress immunity system. Mean it will sleep white blood cells for some time. So what is the drawback of cyclosporin? Drawback of cyclosporin, lot of symptoms the patient will feel. The drawback you can remove by using steroids, which are also not good for health. Dexa, you know, steroid, currently UK declared treatment against corona. Naturally, steroids are not a liking medicine for the doctors because they destroy immunity system. And if anybody doctor is using steroid, that is not understood in medical science, good doctor, because that is not true procedure to treat the patient, because antibiotic is the better way. The inhalation of disease or curing of the disease will be little late, but that is a legal way to cure the disease. By decreasing white blood cell is not the solution, and that is not even prohibited in some developed countries, but in the Pakistan, steroid, dexa, dipyran is being used. But currently, the United Kingdom, you are watching the research going on in different countries, and they got information that the steroid is very useful. Even they are using in Pakistan also now. The doctors are using steroid, and so these medicines are becoming expensive. They were very cheap. So this was discussion. So steroid technically doctor use who have no better idea about a disease, and they just give the steroid that decrease number of the white blood cells, but the person will be okay after 2 hours. You will get the fees as well, because the patient will be very happy that within 3 hours my disease is cured. But this is not a legal way to cure the disease, because you are weakening him step by step by decreasing the number of the white blood cells. But here in this case we can give the steroid. As in the corona cases, the doctors are using, because corona is a severe case, so you can give steroid, no issue. Here in this case, you can also give the steroid. So steroid will be given to prevent the symptoms due to usage of the cyclosporin. Immunosuppressive drug, yes, you can write here. I was thinking the slide was not ready. That's why I told you to write IMMUNOSUPPRESSIV, immunosuppressive drugs. So uremia and stage renal disease is called uremia, and immunosuppressive drug is used. And also when you are going to transplant the kidney, immunity system will not accept the organ. This is called tissue rejection, and you need to use immunosuppressive drugs, but cyclosporin is used more. For we are mentioning the donor kidney must be matched. Mean blood groups is normal thing. Matching of blood group is not the area. I was talking about leukocytogen. You know, when you will produce antigens, leukocyte and antigen antibodies will combine. Blood groups should be matched, and you have to control immunity system, antigen antibody system, and this antibody and antibody antigen system must be matched also, and such antibodies should be controlled also. Cyclosporin medicine will be given to the patient to reduce the tissue rejection from immunity system. Just you are sleeping, this is a word which I was using, you have slept immunity system for some time, cytokines and steroid hormones can be used, steroids chemicals can be used to wave off the side effect of cyclosporin. So we were studying excretory system. Now I will go to almost similar topic in the next, almost similar topic, because this is a homeostasis, but I will discuss how the temperature is maintained. I will keep revising these informations also. Thank you very much.